Hi, how you doing? This is Rich from Rich TV Live. I'm here with a very special guest. It's Dan Mitry, the CEO of New Wave Esports. How are you doing today, Dan?
I'm great. Thank you for having me.
Oh, thank you for being here. Why don't we get started with you telling us a little bit about your background with New Wave Esports?
Sure, yeah. So I'm a 17-year video game industry veteran. I sat on the publisher and developer side. So I very much understand how games are developed, how games resonate with our gamers and those ecosystems and the lifestyles that are created out of the IP that we take live. Then on the publisher side, I've worked very much on global marketing campaigns and started community engagement programs and understanding how gamers get connected with our brands. And that's all very important because we've seen a lot of different transitions from box product to the digital formats of buying video games, from MySpace to Twitch and YouTube as influencer spaces, and now from just ship a game to the live service component of games, which, you know, builds another 5 to 6, 7 years on games that are live. And that's where esports comes into play. Esports is very much a retention tactic. And so I bring all of my experience in gaming by working with Electronic Arts, THQ, Sega of America, and all these other great companies and franchises like Battlefield and Madden and NBA and FIFA, all these inherently competitive titles. We bring all this expertise around collaborations and partnership and sponsorship opportunities over to New Wave Esports. Now, I'm joined by my financial counterparts that are great at raising capital, building great businesses, and we're this double-headed dragon that is New Wave Esports. And so we seek to acquire, invest, and develop technologies by deploying working capital into small and mid-stage companies. And I'll end by saying we're unlike your traditional investment group where, hey, here's a check. We'll check in every quarter to see how that's performing. We actually get very involved in our companies. We take advisory roles many times. We sit within the C-level executive teams, and we drive strategy and executions and understanding where new revenue opportunities lie and create better businesses.
That's great. Now, New Wave Esports is focused on investment verticals and acquisitions, which you touched on. Can you tell us a little bit about some of the companies you've invested in?
Sure, yeah. So we invest in 4 different sectors within gaming. That's number one, teams, leagues, organizations. Secondly, platforms and networks. Third, events and activations. And then finally, technologies and tools. And so one of the investments we placed, a significant investment in, is Team Lazarus. They're one of Canada's premier teams owned and operated by Tidal Gaming. So we very much work closely with Charlie Watson, their CEO, David Breeson, their president, and help strategize how they're going to grow their organization. Now, if you haven't heard of Team Lazarus recently, certainly they made some major headlines. They took home $3.5 million in the Fortnite World Cup.
Yes.
Yeah, they won.
I heard.
Second in the duos, fourth in the singles, and that put them on the map.
Wow.
What I like about Lazarus is they have 50-plus players worldwide. They operate in 10 different countries across 12 different games, so they have a diversified background. They're competing in all sorts of different tournaments, but they have one of the first all-women's esports teams.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, they collaborated with SHEIZ, so they're pushing esports forward from a diversity angle. Love Lazarus, and what they're doing is certainly making waves in the industry. One of our second investments is Playline. Playline is a daily fantasy sports platform available on mobile iOS, Android, and web, and they're bringing in an esports component. They have been bottom line profitable. They're killing it, and people love going to their site and betting on the outcome of matches. So you can walk away with a cool million in hand if you actually were to predict every stat in line.
Wow.
Yeah. So they're contributing to the esports in a way that the global community can engage in. Thirdly, on the events and activations pillar, we invested in a company called Even Matchup Gaming. They run and operate the biggest Super Smash Brothers tournaments in Canada and in the tri-state area with majors called Get On My Level and Let's Make Moves. They're partnered with Nintendo. They've got great non-endemic sponsorship interests such as Red Bull. And what they're doing, they are boots on the ground. They are the energy of esports in an on-site component. So if you've ever been to an esports event, the energy is insane.
I haven't, but you're making me want to go.
No, it's wild. Because you're there, and you can buy merchandise. There's food and beverage, but then you're also watching what's happening on stage. A lot of the time, these kids have their their the Twitch stream up on their phone. Wow. So they're engaging with all their fans and chatting. So they're hyper-engaged audiences, and even Matchup Gaming has certainly dialed in and optimized that sector. And then fourthly, we have technology and tools. So as esports solutions, or excuse me, there's needs in esports, we're developing solutions to meet those needs. And that may be additional platforms, it may be tools that better understand our audiences, so building better business intelligence in order to build better businesses.
Oh, that's great. Now, what would be your mission statement, considering you're in the fastest growing esports industry?
Yeah. Look, we're passionate about gaming. We're passionate about esports. I've built my career on this. And so my mission statement is to create something sustainable and contribute back to an ecosystem that has been thriving. And so we do that by building great businesses that each individually not only run and operate in their own silo, but collaborate with other businesses within the esports ecosystem. So we're building something that has resilience, and resiliency is very important as we have rise and fall of economies, but gaming has always been recession-proof. And since the dawn of playing video games, we've always wanted to watch people play games better than we could. So look, esports is going to be here for a while, and New Wave Esports is here to contribute to that.
That's great. Now, with esports on pace to becoming a billion-dollar industry, there are a lot of companies looking to catch on to the hype. How does New Wave Esports set itself apart from the competition?
Yeah, so we're, like I said previously, we're unlike your traditional investment group. We're not just going to cut a check and then check in every quarter to see how that's doing. We actually get very involved. So many times we do take advisory roles and we incentivize that, whether it's with stock options or whatever that may be. But we want to see businesses flourish, and we want to contribute our expertise within the gaming side of things. So whether that's those relationships with publishers and developers, understanding where games are starting to take off or where they may go in the future, but also bringing all that great sponsorship revenue over, bringing in other collaborations and partnerships with non-endemic and endemic brands. And then on the financial side, being able to raise more capital, contribute to development costs, and seeing those companies expand.
That's great. Now, your team is filled with professionals from finance and gaming. Tell us more about the team that you've put together.
Sure, yeah. So my side, gaming side, I'm the gaming guru. And so I bring in Trouble Fisher. He's a 13-year financial expert. He has raised significant capital within cannabis and mining and brings all of that expertise over to esports. And he's also co-led several hedge funds. So he gets money. He knows how to exercise money and how to place that intelligently and see that flourish. And I'm also joined by Clayton Fisher here in Vancouver. And so between us three, we really are pushing the industry forward within esports. But I also have a network of advisors, and they're boots on the ground, whether they're video game marketers or they're financial experts. They have a global footprint. So we're looking at esports from a global scale and continuing to develop new opportunities within Asia and within Europe. So as we go live here pretty soon, we're going to have a global presence.
That's great. Now, congratulations. I heard on September 19th, it was announced that New Wave Esports will be trading under the symbol NWES on the CSE, the Canadian Securities Exchange. When can our viewers expect the trading to start?
That's still a secret. I'm still waiting on the CSE to give me that final date, but we are looking at the end of October.
For our investors that are watching, it's very important for Rich TV Live members to know about a company share structure. What's your share structure look like?
Currently, we have 72 million shares outstanding with about approximately 50 million in warrants. We're excited with the way that's netted out. So as we go live, you know, a lot of these warrants will be coming in, and that'll just contribute to our expansion at that global scale that we talked about.
Okay, great. And for the investors that are watching all over the world at home, why would they be interested in buying this stock? Why would they want to invest in New Wave Esports?
Yeah, number one, esports is barely tapped. Especially here within North America. Obviously, Asia is certainly significantly ahead of us. Europe has some great collegiate scenes, but here in North America, we're at the ground level. Get in early to get those multipliers coming in. Secondly, we're the experts here. We understand where some of the greatest growth opportunities are. We're very close with the esports companies. We're close with the publishers and developers. So let us do the hard work for you and vet all those deals coming in. And thirdly, we have a diversified portfolio. That's important to, again, create resiliency in a booming market. So as one sector may rise and be quite profitable, we're going to continue putting our resources and our expertise into that. But where some may stagnate, we'll analyze that and we'll dial in how we can build that back up again. So resiliency is key here.
Okay, great. And without giving away too much, what can investors be excited about for new wave esports in the near future?
So as we go live, we're going to continue expanding our portfolio, certainly bring in some quite attractive deals that we're assessing out right now in Asia, but we're also bringing in the European subsidiary. So we are very much going to have a global footprint. We'll have that global presence because esports is a global phenomenon.
Absolutely.
We don't want to just operate in North America, so we are spreading our wings.
That's great. And where can viewers find more info on the company?
Check us out at newwaveesports.com or any social network that you're at. So we're there. We've got great content coming out on the daily. You can learn more about us, and you can always just reach out to us. We'd love to have a chat.
Okay, great. Well, thank you so much for your time today, Dan. This is Dan, the CEO of New Wave Esports. This is Rich from Rich TV Live. Have a nice day.